things have been discovered by pretty much everybody at this point. So there's not really much point to uploading them. I guess we'll just upload the funny moments or something if we gather enough and we feel happy with it. For now, Ash needs help with a mission, so I'm gonna give him some help with that, tips and tricks on how to complete it, and maybe we can do some other things on the side. We'll see. Anyway, let's get to it then, shall we?
By the way, I'm just gonna interrupt and say, fuck quiet mission, fuck it hard.
Yeah, considering some people probably don't know what you're talking about, maybe you shouldn't discuss it.
I know, but they know what I'm talking about once they reach it, and they're gonna say fuck it too.
This is the mission you want, right? Basically, you wanna know how to extract all the prisoners.
Mm-hmm. I want to know their locations, because they're all over the fucking map.
Right. Heading to Afghanistan. So we will start off near the palace, let's see. Yeah, I think this is okay. Deploying. The first one is the easiest because, as you see, like, actually I'm not gonna tell you because it's funner that way. You'll see.
I see you have the basic machine gun.
I like keeping it simple, so I use basic equipment most of the time. I don't take with me something that I'm not gonna need.
I have low spec and high spec versions of each gun. Your objective is to eliminate. They only cost like a couple, like 100 or so, so I can go out on a mission and just enjoy without having to spend so much money on the high tech gear.
Now let's just hope my game doesn't hiccup at times, because when I'm trying to do too many things at once, it does tend to happen from time to time. Let's see.
I still think this mission would have been so much better if it had an actual battle going on.
And that's number one.
Ah. Okay. Senpai, why are you so good? Wow, he was right by his. Oh, she was right there.
Now, unfortunately for this next part, I am not fast enough to grab that vehicle, so I'm just gonna fucking destroy it. And we'll move on from there.
By the way,
oh shit!
Did you know?
Okay, change of plan.
Did you know that that wormhole is a louder than the culture?
Yeah.
Because every time I used it, I found people coming after me, and I was like, huh. Well, maybe I should.
What are you? Ah, fuck, it doesn't matter.
So I decided not to use the.
Wait, what? That thing's supposed to be destroyed, it didn't die in one shot? Fuck me! Last time it died.
Nah, I'm flipping.
Weird. Oh well. Right, so this is gonna slow us down a bit.
Boss, we have information. No, it's a tank. Yeah, I was gonna say, it's a tank that supported you. That's the thing though, your first shot only immobilized it, it's... Oh no, it didn't, it's keep moving. Wow, that rocket launcher just sucks.
Oh, you really have got it. That's good enough. Let's go. We don't have much time to waste around here, so...
One of the vehicles
is gonna
get hit.
Yeah, usually those things die in one shot, I guess I didn't time my shot perfectly. Oh well.
I'm not sure, but I think their weakest point may be
the weakest point is always the back. Right, am I hitting the right way? Where's the... Oh fuck, there we go. I was about to make a mistake and waste some time.
Mistakes were made.
Not really. So 12 minutes should be more than enough. I'm not sure what happens to them if you don't manage to do it in the timeline. Some of them die, some of them don't. But really, I don't care. As long as I make it happen. Why is the alcohol not working? Am I too far?
No.
Oh, my rocket didn't respawn. Whatever, doesn't matter. You can still get it, but it's not important. We're not going for that right now, so... Okay, he's still alive, perfect. Let's not waste time just in case. Yeah, they're almost to him, I can't waste time. I'll just kill him.
Clouds approaching.
Remember, there is also a task to extract all four of those guys, so...
Yeah, I've already done that, so I don't care. Right, that's the fourth one.
You keep getting signals to chain your foes together. You could have taken all four of them out.
Nah, I don't like that stuff.
But it's exactly what you're doing, but faster.
I don't like doing that stuff.
You're weird. I don't like being more efficient.
That basically locks you in a sequence. I don't like that.
As long as you keep going with the sequence.
I don't like doing that. Anyway, I'm the one helping you. Why are you judging me? What the fuck? I thought you wanted to help with this mission and I'm helping you. Stop being such a pussy about it.
Oh, here's a tip for this mission. If to extract all the vehicles, probably the best place is to set up some decoys. Because the trucks and stuff will stop to fire a new decoy, and when they stop, that means you can fault them.
Yeah, thanks, Captain Obvious. Also, basically all the trucks go to one area, so you can just wait for them there. So you don't actually have to run around doing anything, you can just wait for them.
Actually, if you do that, then the timer will probably run out before all the trucks make it to you.
No, you'll have 2 minutes left.
Huh.
Yeah, but you're not gonna get an S rank for that. To get an S rank, you actually have to go and like proactively take them out.
I found out that the bonus objectives on this map are like... give you tons of, so I got an S rank even though I spent about 5 minutes getting all the prisoners. Well, apart from ones that fucking died.
So honestly, this mission will be way easier with decors, but I just prefer to have DD so I know everything around me. Because there's just barely enough time to do the objective without any trouble, so... Yeah, let's take them out. Oh.
Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated.
So yeah, this is pretty much exploiting the reflex mode, I'd say, but whatever.
You fucking cheater. This is also how you get trucks.
Yep. You just stand in front of the truck, reflex mode kicks in, and you just headshot the driver and you're done. Right, time to take the next one.
Well, the people in the trucks are some of the most highly trained.
Well, now that I have the penetrating glass for the trunk, I can actually do that as well, but it's too much work. Plus, I don't like that one.
Development project has been
it costs
added.
Too much for what it offers, it's not worth it.
What do you mean, the penetrating glass trunk?
Yeah.
I got a mate, it'll probably be more valuable if you're in, oh I say, a building. Do you know what would also stop them? If you put a box in the middle of the road.
Head for the remaining target.
Right. That's number 4, to left.
The prisoner we rescued provided some intel. We now know the location of
the last one should be fine. He's left wandering and they don't find him, so should be around here somewhere, should be fine. Here is gonna help us find him quicker, so. I think he probably made his way to the end of the river by now. It's been a while. Come on, where are you?
I'm wondering if the
Oh, there we go. Is there? Yeah, he made it all the way down. If you come earlier in the mission, he's gonna be wandering somewhere under the bridge. But since it's been a while, he made it all the way to the end. Right, we've got just under 6 minutes to get the last one, so this one's gonna be the toughest considering where we did and we don't get a transport vehicle, but whatever.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Ah, when you're running you can't grab them on the run. Oh well. Fucking flowers. Oh, and on our way there we'll be able to earn a little extra cash because the vehicle's probably gonna pass by us, if I remember correctly. Yeah, it's coming right for us, so we'll get one more.
It's coming right for us!
There it is, it's coming.
The offensive will be ending soon.
Those guys.
Boss, there's still time left. Take out as many vehicles as you can.
We'll go. I probably can't waste time trying to extract it, so I'll just destroy it.
It's not like the mission immediately ends at, like, when it reaches zero.
See, that one was a single shot, what the fuck?
Target has left the mission area.
Oh well.
You just hit it better.
Yeah, I guess I hit it better. Right, 4 minutes, let's get that last guy.
Here's the thing, what's your favorite rocket launcher or missile launcher?
My favorite rocket launcher is probably the one before this one that doesn't have the auto-aim. Not sure what it was called.
The recoilless rifle?
I'll check it later. But yeah, this is definitely not my favorite one. I'm actually using this one because I have so much minor materials that I literally can't waste them. But for the last platform I needed a lot of common materials, so I've been saving up because that basically the rocket launcher I like uses those. Yeah, last night I upgraded my last platform, so I'm pretty much done with the main mother base and now I'm upgrading the FOB.
I'm just currently upgrading my FOB to at least 2 platforms per thing.
If you don't wanna get attacked and lose materials, upgrade everything to level 1, past that you start losing materials. Aww, what the hell?
It was a bit too late for that. So. Run, 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 run. By the way, you know there's a secret route you ran past, right? That leads straight into it.
Yeah, I know, but fuck it. Oh shit! That guy got me good. Fucking hell. Oh no. Gotta rest. So much fucking shotguns. Like, what the fuck? What? How are you shooting me? Oh, wait. What the fuck is behind the shield? Oh.
What happened? Boss!
Oh, that was dumb. Fuck. It's gonna restart the mission, isn't it?
We're back up for the Guerrilla's offensive
operation. Yep. You're gonna have to restart from the very beginning because the checkpoints in this game suck ass. Just saying.
Yeah, that's fine. I pretty much showed you where all the prisoners are. You can do the rest yourself, so.
Yes, thank you for sharing me
the
last prisoner.
The last one is, you know, in the underground. You know, mission 3 or 4 where you got the biotic SARM guy. He's basically in the same holding cell. And that's it. So yeah, it's pretty easy. Yeah, here's my new logo that I kinda reworked. I used the Peace Walker like background and put in Zuril Nuclear. Basically, the only FOBs I infiltrated are the ones with nukes so I can disarm them. So that's kind of the theme I was going for.
For some kind of reason I can't find any FOBs with nukes. They don't show up yet.
I'm pretty sure you're just not looking hard enough. Basically, when you are scouting where you see like their manpower and resources, on the bottom right there's one empty slot. If they have nuke, it's gonna pop up that they have nukes there.
Yeah, there's a tab for it when you search for it. It just none of them comes up.
No, not there. Let me show you because you're being confused again. I'll show you. Oh yeah, I'm offline because the online shit don't work right now, so I can't actually show you. Never mind. Basically, when you go on an Alpha Beam mission and you look for targets to infiltrate, it's gonna pop up there when you're looking what kind of resources and stuff they have. It's gonna pop up as an icon that they have any number of nukes. Fuck, I can't even check my security stuff. I want to show like how many S rank soldiers I have. Because I have so much heroism, they basically like pop up everywhere I go.
Unit
so
dispatched.
I pick up like 3 or 4 on every run I do, pretty much. Right.
How much heroism you got? Oh, I've got actually a bit more than you.
A bit what now?
I got a bit more heroism than you.
Oh, you've managed to farm some. Good.
No, I've just been playing. I'm just overall more heroic. I guess it's because I've actually done all the like main dispatch missions as well. But you have tons more money than me. I wish I had that much.
Nah, that's not that much.
I've been developing every single gun I can get my hands on though. So I think that's
the problem. Here's the thing, dude. Check this out. I've got like 22,000 precious materials. That translates to, let's see, each one of them is worth 1,000. So just add 3 zeros behind all that. I've got like over 22 millions just from fucking that.
True, but that some of the best stuff in the game needs precious materials to take
out.
Yeah,
and I've developed all of it, so I don't need that shit. So pretty much I'm sitting on 21 million cash. Just like precious materials are so easy to farm, it's crazy. And they give off so much shit.
Yeah.
Right. Speaking of which, let's see where we can find. You know what? I've been meaning to redo that mission to see if it was a fluke. Let's see if it continues giving amazing amount of heroic points. Where was that one with Cold Talker, I think?
Ah, you mean getting the ladies. By the way, what level of Fulton do you need to extract them?
I don't know, I think it's just a mission thing. After a while it lets you do it. Or you needed to complete some side ops, was it? I don't fucking remember, dude. Eventually as you play the game it's gonna let you do that. But on the first time when you reach them, you're not gonna be able to do it. Ah, this is enough. Christ. Don't wanna take something to make things easier. Not going for rank. You know what, that's fine, it's fine. Just go like this.
Deploying.
Yeah, that sniper rifle that I took, usually I like prefer taking the weaker version because it wastes less resources, and as long as you aim well enough, like the scope difference is just nullified. So basically, take the smaller one and rely more on skill rather than take the better one. If you wanna save up on some plants. But honestly, at this point in the game, you should have thousands and thousands of plants. They're just for money at this point.
I wonder where we store the plants.
3,000 plants, man. I don't know where to store that. The annoying thing is that there's a limit to how much GMP you can have. The limit is 5 million, so you can't have more than that. So you gotta start spending it after that point.
But what can you spend it on after you've developed everything?
Security. It costs money to have security.
Man.
And it can get pretty fucking expensive, trust me. Especially if you have more than one FOB, it gets crazy. Oh, by the way, speaking of taking out snipers, do you know an easy way to take out Quiet? If you don't wanna, if you wanna get all her achievements in an S rank? Do you know how to do it?
Mm-hmm.
With, you know, the drops?
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, by the way, I have a feeling that is the only way to get her without non-lethal weapons. Because there's no way you can sneak up on her.
Yes, you can.
You can?
Yes.
Wow. Super sneaky.
But trust me, it's super fucking hard.
Yeah. I tried without a sneaking suit and I was like, come on. Ow.
Wait, without the sneaking? Oh no, wait. Without the sneaking suit, I think it's pretty much impossible.
Yeah, she kept kicking my ass with grenades. So but I did it eventually. I was like, goosh, goosh, wow, that was super fast. And it only cost me 6,000 GMP.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, dude. Like basically you drop through boxes on crackhead and it's over. Oh, and by the way, on extreme you can't do that shit, she runs away.
Ah, cheating bitch.
Of course. Right, so I was actually considering how to do this, but you know what, I'll just do it the old fashioned way. I'll just take him out.
It's a shame there's only like 40 missions, but still.
And I've been discovered. Good for now, don't care.
Sniper, where are they?
By the way.
Oh shit!
Why is this the only place you meet these women?
I don't know. Don't ask me, man. Didi, really? Now's not the time to stand in my way, Didi.
Didi, no.
Okay, that's two. Oh, almost.
You see that?
And she vanished. Okay. Next. Oh shit! Like no!
If you can't mark them, there's no way to tell where they'll strike from next.
There we go, we're fine.
Stay on your guard.
By the way, I like that scope you have. Is that a rangefinder scope?
A what now?
The scope you have on your rifle.
I don't know, it's just the basic one. I don't customize my weapons at all. Fuck. There we go.
I have one that can zoom
find
into...
For me.
By the way, it's so hilarious just seeing you hop about like...
Yeah, that hop about is broken, dude. It's so fucking good, it's crazy. Oh, I can't see them from here. I can just see their laser.
Sleepy.
It would help if Didi... Dude, don't just stand up, what the fuck? It would help if Didi could, like... spot them from that distance, but oh well.
I can't believe you have Didi naked right now. Don't
yeah,
you love
no
him?
Yeah, no point, because I don't use his skills. Why waste cash on that shit?
Because the armor still protects him.
Yeah, he's fine. He can take a shot or two.
And besides, you're so rubbish not using DD skills, because DD skills are awesome. First, using the knife for the first time is unbelievable.
Meh. Not a fan.
It's like, fucking ninja dog! Holy crap!
I'm gonna pet him, though. Good boy. Oh shit! No! Don't kill me while I'm petting my dog! Right. Next. What are you, bitches? Let's go.
I love the panicking you do.
There we go. That's one more. Where the other ones? Come on.
Snipe them, snipe them
closer,
good.
I don't care, I'm not afraid! I'm not afraid!
Have you ever tried sneaking up on these women?
Nah. I will later when I'm having fun, but right now I just wanna check out the farming.
To be honest, I cheated in this mission the first time. Because I used quiet.
That's not cheating, you're just using a body. Come on, where are you?
Yeah, but the thing is, I hid while she got over them. I was like, I might as well not do anything. I just relaxed. I was like, you doing okay, quiet? Ow! Yeah, you're fine.
Right, so where's the fourth one, bro? Now that gets me a little worried. Why can I not see her? Is she trying to surprise me?
This is where she comes up behind you.
Yeah, they actually do approach you if you're hiding too much. And they use a machete. But as you can see, I'm not hiding at all, so...
Only if they know where you are.
Yeah, they gotta know where I am, of course. What are you, bitch?
Now, the problem with my original tactic for... quiet...
Oh, there we go.
Is that there's four of them. So the first time I tried my tactic of run towards them like a bad man with my pistol drawn.
There's the fourth one.
It didn't work.
One more. And we're done. Come on. Come on, babe, let's do this. Where are you?
Let's do this like we do it on the animal planet.
Where'd you go? Come on, fight me! I guess she doesn't want to fight me.
No, come back and fight me! I am super strong.
No, seriously, where are you? Oh, there we go. Okay, one more shot and she's done. Oh yeah, because she doesn't know where I am, that's why it's so fucking hard. Oh! Wait, she knows now. Fuck it.
Don't tell me you took them all out. That's incredible, boss.
Now let's collect our prize. So yeah, when we complete this mission, we should make like around 40k for this.
30k heroism?
Yep.
And also get some parasites.
Yeah, but I don't need them anymore, so I think I'm done with the parasite armor. Apart from the last skill, that's pretty annoying, so I don't care about it. the armor and the stealth is good enough. Come on, let's go. Actually, one of these times I wanna try sneaking past them, but not with the stealth stuff, just, you know, the regular way, to see how it plays out then, and get an S rank like that, basically Phantom, without any detections, without anything, leaving no traces. That's what I wanna try.
True, that would be some skill. I wonder what the dialogue is like, because
yeah, that's what
dialogue changes. He's like, oh, they know you took out the skulls. I was like, ooh, they do. I'm awesome. But I wonder what happens if you keep them alive.
Yeah, and they never spot you. I wanna try that. Should be fun.
Like, if you let no one spot you at the end where they go, where they start searching, do they just not ever search?
By the way, you're keeping tabs on chat, right?
You're right at the mansion. Of course.
Since I'm busy. Close. Okay. Be sure to think this through. Right. Let's see.
Fairy so, Flame Plays says hello. We say hello back.
Hello.
Hello.
So, this, you said yourself that you miss, like, inside buildings and infiltration from previous games, like, right, this is pretty much the closest thing that we get to that, pretty much.
Yeah, it's,
and it's
sad.
So disappointing that you can go from the back and pretty much like get to him instantly. You can avoid the entire fucking mansion.
Exactly. And I really do miss interiors. Like, there's nothing happening here, right? Between outposts anyway. No. So
It's not like there's nothing happening. Some trucks like go through and about, but that's about it.
Don't get me wrong, this is a fantastic game, but I feel like all the commotion with Konami and Kojima leaving may have neutered it a little bit from what it was going to be. Because it felt like there was going to be so much more.
So, I kinda do not wanna extract these guys. So that means I either have to kill them or I have to double neutralize them. That's too much work. You know what? Fuck it, I'll just... Where is that guy going? He's never done that before. What the fuck? Where are you going, bro? No, seriously, where are you going?
Hey guys, we've got Chief over here. See ya. Looks like they're already
on guard. Fuck. Is he armored up the ass or something? They might know the target's exact location. Fuck you. Just fuck you. Oh, my aim is so shit today. You know what? It's fine. Oh, whatever. I'm not doing this for the rank anyway, let's just hurry up. Alright, fuck. Oh, I forgot about this part, I can't go in like this. Ah. Oh. They're not even gonna come here, what's the point? Fine, I guess I'll wait. Oh shit, the sniper's out. Okay, so we gotta switch to this, that's fine. Nice one. Come on, hurry up.
Yeah, if you bother to
I should've just killed them, that's what I should've done.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, if you actually customize your weapons, your sniper rifle silencer would be grade 2. And it would last much longer. But no, it's fine.
Eh, don't care. Come on! Here's the worst part. They actually neutralized them. I didn't kill them, so they're gonna wake up eventually. Ugh. Gonna kill them on the way out.
Okay, by the way, I just want to say, you know the last mission you did, right? You know, prisoner in the mountains. That one is the cyberneticist, right?
Yeah.
And he's the timed one. So in other words, you can't upgrade how tough you are unless you specifically know that guy is going to be there.
But he's too old to risk a Fulton extraction.
So?
Put Code Talker in the chopper and return to base.
Dude, I completed the entire game without knowing that you can upgrade your resistance. You can do without it.
Dude, I'm already at the end. There's only one more mission to go.
Well, don't complain about it. You never needed him, right? Big deal.
I just felt like I missed out on so much.
Yeah, you missed out on not dying as easily, so you can be more Rambo and Call of Duty style. Oh no, big deal.
No, not really, just...
So the annoying part here is that we actually have to wait for this fucker to save his lines. We can't rush for this, so... Luckily it's just the first time if you fail, so don't worry about it. After that you can just run.
That's because what he has to say is important.
Well, yeah. The first time. When you're replaying the mission, not so much.
And Code Talk is a boss. You know what? I think I'm gonna hit at something.
You're gonna what now?
I said I'm gonna hint at something. There's another gonna be. We're gonna be making another game. And we're discussing which system to use.
Yeah, you this know, is so relevant idea. To the current video, dude.
Yeah, what are we gonna do while you're walking with Code Talker?
Well, I'm done.
Anyway. You've still got to go to a heli. And I'm not sure you're gonna make it. And then, besides, it's gonna be Metal Gear, so it is relevant.
Come on, go away. Don't come this way. Okay, that's good enough for me. Let's go. You guys gonna get alerted?
I was actually thinking of basing it before the first Metal Gear and right after this one.
Wait, what?
Because everybody's alive.
Did I not hit him the first time? That was good. Doesn't matter now.
By the way, I just want to say, this is bullshit. We all know Code Talker can, like, do whatever. So, he should get off your back and help.
Yeah, but if you had to protect him and he's just walking around, how exactly are you gonna protect him?
Dude, protect him? He's got parasites up the ass. I bet he could rip every single one of these fuckers in two.
Yeah, he pretty much looks like it, doesn't he?
Yeah, but did you... Right, you know, tiny bit of spoilers. Right, did you hear the conversation in the cassette tape?
I've listened
tape?
To all the tapes in the game.
Exactly. Did you hear how he kicked Skullface's ass? That old man is a
you
lying
don't know
piece
what
of shit.
He did. That's all I'm gonna
bullshit,
say about that.
Bullshit. Code Talker's a badass.
Fuck me, no. Not like dust. Not like dust, bruh.
Maybe he has some sort of super shrunk parasites.
Wait, they immediately got alerted? That wasn't right. No wait, they're not alerted, never mind. Let's just kill him. Is he dead? Is he just wounded? Wounded's good enough for me, let's go. Oh shh.
So mouse is a good
So, as you can see, I'm rushing like pretty recklessly through this because I don't care about rank or anything, I just wanna finish the mission. But yeah, this is definitely not advisable to do. By any stretch of the imagination.
Don't do this.
Here, let me put you out of your misery, dude. At least you'll die unconscious. Why can I hit you so you can get knocked out?
By the way, I just want to say, has anybody ever used one of the lethal pistols in this game?
Never.
Exactly. I have no idea why they're there. I mean, there were in every other game as well, but it's just strange. It's like when you can take soldiers. Ah, you're so kind, putting him asleep so he may die that way. Despite you only actually shooting his arm. He's fine. His friends will find him.
Yeah, and yeah, I still have the slow chopper because I'm a cheapskate like that.
Can't believe you haven't kitted out your chopper.
Well, I've bought all the upgrades, I just don't wanna use them because they make the prices of the chopper go up the ass.
Dude, you have millions!
Still don't wanna waste that cash. What's the point? I'll just wait a little longer. See, he's coming, it's okay.
Fucking 2 minutes. Mine arrives in like 10 seconds. Admittedly though, while yours cost about 6,000, mine cost about 30,000. Look at DD just growling away. When are you gonna go to Zanzibar?
So yeah, let's check out if we can get like a good amount of heroism again. Last time it was like 40k, let's see what we get this time around. Wait, an S rank? Really? That was such a bad mission. How can you give me an S rank for that?
You clearly S ranked it. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh my god, that was just embarrassing. Anyway, yeah, let's see the important part. Oh, fuck you! What the fuck? Last time it gave me 40 fucking K! Fuck you, game. Oh. We found the bodies of the two. Yeah, yeah, whatever. I don't care. Why didn't you give me the full heroism? What the fuck? Zero risk security.
Wow, capturing the... Eliminating the skulls actually gave you so much.
Yeah, whatever. Come on, hurry up. There
we go. So yeah, if you want... It's actually quite easy to S-rank this mission, apparently. All you have to do is eliminate the skulls.
Honestly, like I said, I wanna do it full stealth without eliminating or raising any alarms. That's what I wanna try doing.
S-rank. S-rank. Yeah, right now, the only people in my waiting room are all the ordinary soldiers. And I'm just like, I should fire you all.
Yeah, well, the game does that automatically for you. It gets rid of the weakest soldiers for you, so no point doing that.
Yeah, you're not allowed to pick.
Let's see. We'll keep you. This one's already locked. Locked, okay, I think the rest are fine. Oh, I'm at 99 out of 99, so fuck it. Whatever, doesn't matter now. Now, can we try to go back online, please?
Now we see staff management.
By the way, if somebody has any questions in chat, let me know so we can show them some tips and tricks on stuff, like collecting materials and all that important stuff. Oh my god, somebody attacked me while I was offline. How is this fucking fair? Screw you. Oh, I couldn't defend myself. Well, I lost nothing, so it doesn't really matter, but still. Oh, that's so fucking dumb. Yeah, I've lost just soldiers. I haven't even lost materials. Whatever. Thanks, team. Thanks for letting me defend myself. Oh shit, I gotta apply soldiers. Whatever. I didn't lose anything, so it doesn't matter. That's the thing about this game, you gotta realize that no matter what you lose, you don't actually lose anything. Like, it doesn't matter. If you lose soldiers, you can just get more. If you lose materials, you lose only the unprocessed ones, so it doesn't fucking matter. So yeah, no wait, that was not here. Security settings. Yeah, I've got almost 80 S soldiers, and these are basically from me running around and completing side ops. Like, literally, they're dropping like candy. Like, you go to some small godforsaken outpost and you see like 2 or 3 S rank soldiers with this kind of heroism. So, instead of farming soldiers on some missions like mission 19 when they all get knocked out, that's a waste of fucking time. Get your heroism up to 200-250,000, and from that point on, you just get all the legendary soldiers you want. You do not have to like waste your time farming soldiers. That's dumb. It's a waste of time doing that. Don't farm soldiers.
Please specify a project.
Well, let's see if we've got something else I need.
Defense failed.
Oh, there we go. Yeah, since I got that guy last time, it's time to upgrade my medical shit. Right. Next. So, very disappointing. I didn't manage to get like a good chunk of heroism again. Maybe it just happens the first time. I don't know. But yeah, last time I did that mission, it gave me like 40k heroism for extracting the skulls and completing it. I don't know what I did differently.
By the way, I have a feeling that you can use that anti-tank sniper rifle to take out vehicle crews somehow.
Probably. I'd wager that's a thing. Unit dispatched.
If only you could spot them within their fucking tanks.
Right. So, do you need help with any other mission?
No, I'm good.
But I still haven't done this. I'm kind of saving them for last because I want to have fun with them. Just the extreme ones. So wait, you said that you haven't actually gotten this mission yet, right?
Oh no, I've obtained the truth mission now. I just had to wait.
Did you finish everything?
Nope, not yet. I have to go do it now before.
What about this one?
Before our session. Huh? Hang on, I can't see it.
Truth. The man who sold the world. Basically, that's the end game mission.
Yeah, as I said, I'm gonna have to go and do that now.
You know what? I should do Extreme Cold Talker the same way and see if that rewards me with a bunch of heroism again. You know what? I should have done the extreme version right now. But oh well. Too late fucking now.
By the way, fuck Quiet Exit. Wait, anyway. Oh, you did it without her getting hit.
So, while we're here, do you want me to show you how you can farm materials, at least?
No, it's good, don't worry.
You don't need materials? Okay then.
Nah, I'm good.
What else can we do? Let's see. What else is important? Well, GMP, I guess, but honestly, if you're just... You don't need to farm GMP late game. I guess just early game when you need it, you can just do the occupation forces. We made the video, but yeah, we never really upgraded that. Basically, on this mission, you just stop the convoy that's coming for the village, you put out a few decoys and extract everything. No point doing. This is also a good way to farm your foxhound like rank. Mm-hmm. But that's about it, nothing interesting. On this mission you farm the resources, but you need the wormhole. Basically what happens is you spawn in the hangar, and there's a lot of cool containers, you just extract them. You go and pick up the mission files, the game saves automatically, and after it saves, you just restart the mission. You can farm a lot of fuel, precious materials, and common materials here. So, there you go.
Yes.
No, wait, not common materials. I think it was minor materials. Whatever. By the way, on the Black Mamba mission, did you manage to fulfill the objective where you have to basically, like, not give him a chance to fight back?
I suspect you just have to get to position to snipe him.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. You know what? I want to do that mission just so I can show it. Because that's awesome. where was the Black Mamba? Oh, there we go. The Mamba guy. Yeah.
By the way, I actually got all the tasks on the Black Mamba one. You know, to extract 20 children. I think it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had to do it by helicopter.
Oh my god, really?
Because I didn't have the thing. I was like, I can't just leave these children here. So I started like, mind you can Fulton them. I found this out. I was like, what's a faster way to do this? Ah, I'll just have a car dropped in, pile all the kids in, and then Fulton the car.
Oh my god. Dude, why are you doing that? It's so much easier. Like, later when you go on the platform and face Eli in a one-on-one challenge,
yeah,
it's
I know.
A lot of fun. Honestly, I wish you could replay that because it was so much fun. He gives you the upgrade so you can extract children. But yeah, the thing is, you get that after these missions, which means that basically you cannot 100% the mission on your first try, and that's annoying.
I've 100% missions sometime, but like, for instance, I could have done a white mamba one if I was dedicated enough and I searched for the hidden diamonds and then just sniped Eli.
There was a mission late game that I laughed my ass off because it went like perfectly. Oh, I think it was this one, hunting down. So if you want to hunt soldiers for whatever reason, this is the mission I'd actually recommend, because basically you go into the savannah and you look for a guy that's sneaking his way to a camp, and if you intercept him on the way, he's got like 6 or 7 guards and they're all highly skilled soldiers. So if you extract all of them, you're basically gonna get a lot of good soldiers. At my current heroism, I wonder if they're all gonna be S rank. I'm actually kind of inclined to give it a try. So yeah, basically, I did on my first try, you see, I haven't replayed this mission at all. I got all the side tasks because I was in my phase where I'm literally like, I must steal everything. Yeah, the kleptomaniac phase, which we all go through with this game. So without knowing, I just pretty much completed everything on my first try. I just didn't get the S rank, but think I'm gonna, on the replay when I check out for the S soldiers, I think I'm gonna get the S rank then. Honestly, I wonder if I should do it now, since I know their predicted path, and I'm gonna get Diddy because I can't go with Quiet. You know what? Maybe not. Do I remember where these guys patrol? If I remember correctly, he's trying to make it to this camp, and he doesn't use the main route. So maybe somewhere around this area is where they passed. I'm not 100% sure. So instead of going here to collect files or everything, I can just bolt for this area. You know what? It sounds like fun. We should give it a try. Yeah, let's do it. Right, so we're gonna be knocking them all out. The sniper stays definitely. Everybody likes the Riot SMG. I haven't actually really tried it, but it seems like it's pretty strong. I don't know, for some reason it just doesn't click with me. I should probably get some stun grenades to make this easier. But you know what? Fuck it, don't care. YOLO. Also, I hate the fact that every time you go like on a mission, it says, oh, you've got better equipment of this kind, do you want to equip the better version? That's very annoying. I gotta find a way, if there's a way to turn that shit off.
Boss, the target is a PF logistics officer who works as a human trafficker on the side. The client wants him dead.
I think your first time around through this mission, the soldiers are all gonna be like A+ or A++ rank. Now with the current heroism, let's see if they're affected at all. It should be like a huge difference if they scale properly.
This key should be at the comms facility at the Detani abandoned village. Check your iDroid to see what the target looks like, as well as the location of the village. Find a route.
No.
Find a man.
We're gonna skip all the objectives because I've already completed them. Let's just go to the right area. Oh, target FOM, right. Okay, we're heading straight for him. We're not gonna look for anything. You know what, maybe we should show where to farm the materials just in case somebody doesn't know that yet, but we'll see. Do people in chat have any questions? Like I said, I can't really check them out right now, so make sure you keep an eye on that shit for me, please. Got some animals. Are those jackals? I think there's jackals on this mission. No, they wouldn't be green. Yeah, there's goats. Never mind. Oh, maybe those are the jackals. Yeah, these are suicide objective jackals. There you go.
Crackball. Did you find a way to get S plus rank soldiers besides SOB?
Yes. I get them all the time. I've got like 80 soldiers just from going around completing side ops. Basically, when your heroism is high enough, you get S rank soldiers all the time. You don't need to farm them. They just come to you.
You need very high heroism for you to get S rank soldiers and stuff. So being a hero helps, apparently.
Yeah. I'm not sure apart from the money, but I think disarming nukes not only gets you the achievement, but it also, I think, is supposed to give you heroism on the side as well. So if you wanna do FOBs a lot, you can just disarm nukes. That's an extra bonus you'll get. Alright, so they're supposed to come somewhere around this area. I'm not gonna wait for them, I'm gonna just go ahead. They're gonna be very silently and try to sneak about, but as long as I've got DJ, like, should be relatively easy to find them. The thing is, I don't just wanna find them, I wanna get the jump on them. So that's gonna be a bit harder. Like I said, these guys are skilled soldiers, so let's see if we can get lucky. And not going for any of the side objectives, there's a big chance that they're just nowhere in the area yet. Wait. No, just missing my plants. Okay, Diri, let's keep looking, boy.
Yeah, apparently Crackball has, like, very high heroism, but he's after, like, missions and stuff where you can get S++'s and stuff. Like, S's.
Oh, he wants the extra high ones. Well, I think, like, every time you complete a mission, you know, you get soldiers. Like, for instance, when I replayed the mission, like, a minute ago, I got, like, 2 S ranks. Basically, I think it's still influenced by heroism, but it's just on a very high scale. Basically, maybe after 300, 400, something fucking dumb like that. As long as you farm some heroism, eventually you're gonna start getting the higher ones. But,
yeah, but
by themselves, none of the missions carry that kind of good soldiers. But if there is a mission that carries good soldiers like that, it's probably this one. Let's see what we get with like over 200 heroism on this one, when I start extracting the guys.
Yeah, let's mark these guys and see if it's mission-based as well.
Yeah, if they scale, I should get S ranks and above easily with these guys. Because these guys are always like very high ranked. The thing is, I gotta find them. That's the problem. I'm not using the files right now, so I gotta get lucky.
I think their predicted route, I think that's the start of it, so you may have to go deeper.
Are these the guys? No, definitely not, because they're very high ranked. That's definitely not one of them. It can't be. Enemy presence detected. There's no way that's a guy. Usually they're all A++ or above the first time around, so they've gotta be way higher than this guy. This guy's a loser. Oh! Or maybe he's just the scout, that's why he's weak. Yeah, maybe he's just the scout. Does he have a helmet? No. Why? Right, now let's see. These are probably the guys. So let's see if we get something nice here. I'm curious to see if they scale properly. If they do, these guys are gonna be insane.
Yes,
there they are.
What rank are they?
Let's find out, shall we?
Analysis complete.
A+, okay, he sucks. Let's see. There's still quite a few. We might get lucky. Let's see what we got.
Personally, I've only got stuff analysis like complete.
A apparently plus, they do plus, not plus. Scale, they seem like shit. Yeah, they're all A plus or below. They don't scale. That's disappointing. There's only one like S guy.
Oh, yeah, sucks. I personally, I got S++ on Margo missions moved. Where you're, they come contracted to go and collect prisoners and stuff. Like, I think prisoners have a much higher rate of being S++ than normal dudes.
Is she okay?
Fuck. Oh well, he turned towards me, so that helps. Oh, I got him, but he didn't go down. Okay, there we go. So yeah, unfortunately these guys apparently do not scale, which is very disappointing. Oh well.
You have arrived.
Target extracted. We'll let the client know he's been
dealt with. Let's just leave, I guess.
Yeah, it seems like S++ ranks are hard to get.
Well, they'll eventually become very easy to get, but yeah, right now they are. You just need to get more heroes and that's about it. Let's ignore these guys that can trigger my reflex mode, because fuck that. So I think this should be enough for an S rank, right? And since I already have the objectives, this is probably me done with the mission at this point. I don't think I'm gonna replay it now that I know that the soldiers don't actually scale.
Right, you're out of the hot zone. No enemy forces in pursuit.
There we go.
Mission complete.
Extraction arrived at
base. But hey, at least with this kind of heroism, when you complete the mission, I should get a few S-rank soldiers
right
again.
Is why you're
so,
the best,
yeah,
boss.
Should be fine.
The one and only.
Let's see, yeah, definitely S-rank, okay. It's okay, heroism, I guess, for what we did. Right, let's see what we get. Do we get legendaries? We should. I'm gonna bank two legendary soldiers. That's one.
Anything past...
Just one?
Normal.
Oh my god.
Anything, as I said, anything past normal S rank is probably RNG, to be honest.
Eh. Oh. What's this? Oh, extracted prisoner. You know what? I'm here. Might as well do it, right? I'm so disappointed with that skills mission. Like I said, last time it gave me like 40k. Oh, wait, you know what? Last time I hadn't completed all the side objectives yet. Maybe because I completed everything, that's why it gave me the 40k heroism
caution.
Boost. Oh. Maybe that's why it was like that last time.
Enemy
present
detected. The map
has been updated. Oh, there we go, found him. This is the best thing in the game. You can basically move very rapidly without them spotting you. It's crazy. Crazy good. Right, no side window. I'm gonna have to go from the front. Okay.
Yeah, I think S++ is all like.
Oh wait, I should
RNG
check these guys. Let's see if there's some extra. Oh, there we go. That's the first one. So yeah, when you have high heroism, you just go around. See, we already found an S rank soldier. That's it.
Yeah, S rank is not what he's after. Like S++ and stuff.
Yeah, I guess it's just later. They're basically doing this to prolong the game. They're kind of making sure that you can't just easily obtain them. Like it's easy to obtain an S rank at this point. What? Didn't that hit him? That was weird. There we go. Right, let's see these guys.
Analysis.
You know, when you hit the, like analysis as Crackball says, if you hit like 1 million hero, maybe you start getting S++.
No, that would be way too insane. That's so much heroism. It's gotta be sooner than that. Maybe 300, 400, maybe half a million, but 1 million is just insane, dude. Like, what the fuck? They can't let that be a thing. That's crazy. Oh wait, there's a sniper back there? Is he cool?
Analysis.
Oh, he's an S rank, okay, I'll take him. I need a few more S ranks, why not? Man, this game's crazy. This game is just made for kleptomaniacs. It's insane. So yeah, okay. If somebody doesn't know, when there's a soldier you want and you want to distinguish him from the others, just mark him. You can actually do that. You can mark people. It's very convenient. What? How are you awake? Didn't I... What
the... You gotta extract him.
Whatever. No one talks to him, bro. Bye. Anyway. Well, let's go collect your body and we're done.
Extraction arrived at the mother base.
Come on. Get up there. There we go. Wait, is that a vehicle? Yeah, that's a vehicle. What's good? I'll get it. Mine. Easy bunny. So yeah, don't extract like base defenses like the mortars and such, because people can steal them, not worth it, and they don't give a lot of cash. Just extract vehicles. They're useful for your soldiers and you can sell them for cash and nobody can steal them from them, so I advise getting those instead. But it's not really worth it. Oh, and don't summon the chopper every time, no point. Just return to ACC and you're done. Save money, save time. When you're not on a mission, of course. Because if you're on a mission, it's gonna fail. I guess, apart from completing the missions perfectly one time to get the big heroism boost, the other thing you can do is go on the missions with basically the black, the white Mamba and the other one where there's a lot of kid soldiers. Extracting them also gives like pretty decent heroism. You can find, you can farm heroism there, I guess. But it's a lot more tedious and annoying. I was more looking for big boosts that you don't have to like waste hours doing the same thing over and over, because let's be honest, that's annoying. Who wants to grind like that? That's not fun, right?
Please select a mission. Unit dispatched.
Oh yeah, let's go to the Mamba. You want to see him get disarmed without him, I mean destroyed without doing anything. And I guess we can farm some heroism while we're there. So this should be fun. White
Please
Mamba, let's
select
see.
A mission.
White Mamba, where was that guy? There we go, White Mamba. No, no.
Mission accepted.
We're just gonna keep the current stuff because basically all I need is a sniper rifle. We can save some money by not bringing a firearm because I'm not gonna be using my normal weapon. Fuck it. I'm sitting on so much money that it's fucking pointless at this point. Dude, I remember when GMP was a problem. Man, those were the good old days. And you, when I was scrapping for money.
Capture the White Mamba, the child soldier's commander, and bring him back to Mother Base. First off, head for Bwala Yamasa.
Maybe I should have brought the rocket arm, neutralizing with that, that's always fun. Well, too late now, and I don't wanna go again soon. So yeah, let's see how much the children soldier actually gave heroism wise. If this is another alternative to farming heroism. Oh, there's one that's by himself. No wait, never mind, he's not. I lied. Hello. That's one. Did he notice? He didn't. Okay. Let's grab one of them. Oh, he's in the open door. There we go. Didi, please move out of the way. Ah, oh, miss. No. How could I? fuck it, just put a bot. It's fine. Oh, I'm lazy. Oh, come on, are you all gonna notice? Oh. This sure made things a lot more difficult than it should be.
Yeah, they're children, they shouldn't take so many shots.
Right, let's see what we get.
Gun him down.
You gotta extract him.
Right, so, first of all, he doesn't have a helmet, so let's do that. Yoink! Let's extract a few more, actually, just in case. You know, they're down anyway, might as well. Point just leaving them lying around. Okay, that's enough.
Subject on board.
Don't need the rest. The rest can stay.
Ever since.
480 for 4 kids. Okay, so 120 per kid. There's like 20 kids here total. Times 120 plus the white mamba. Oh, and the prisoner. Right, I forgot about the prisoner.
Fuck prisoner.
So yeah, I guess you can make okay heroism, but this is grindy. I don't like grindy shit. So basically completing the missions comes first, I think. These guys are gonna come here. So let's see if we can avoid them. Well, I hit him, but it wasn't the head apparently. Whatever. Screw you too, game. Hope they're not close enough to here. Don't worry, I gotcha. Okay, now let's hurry up and get out of here before they come back. Grab the diamonds. And
okay, subject is in.
Okay. That's that. Now let's take care of the mamba. Where was it? Oh, over there. Oh, okay. Oh, you're gonna enjoy this a lot, Ash. You know how he has a big smug grin on his face? We're gonna wipe it off his face right now. Basically, what I'd advise if you don't wanna bother with what I'm doing right now is just upgrade your rocket punch and just guide that thing in there and knock him out with that. Or, alternatively, you can wait for like midnight or after that when he goes to bed and you can just sneak up on him and kick him in his sleep or something.
Wait, he has a bedtime?
Yeah. They all have a bedtime. Obviously, they need to sleep. Right, so somewhere around this point should be okay when I stand up, let's see.
That looks like the target.
Oh wait, what? No wait, is he going to bed? What is he doing? Why did he move? Okay, I did not expect that. I guess I wasted too much time and that's why he got up, because I was playing with those children in the first outpost. Basically what you wanna do is get immediately to this point and snipe him as fast as possible from this position. But he moved! Like, what the fuck? Why'd he move? I guess he didn't discover me because he hasn't done anything yet. Is he gonna...
Where's he going?
I don't know. Oh, baby, he's going to bed. Yeah, he's probably going to bed. Yeah, that's what he's doing. But doesn't matter,
so
because I don't want to waste
that's his job. He sits in his chair and then goes to bed.
He sits in his chair, looks menacingly with a big grin, shit-eating grin on his face, and then he just goes to bed. There you go.
I'm gonna kick that child's ass.
So manly, man.
Hey, I did before. By the way, I loved your reaction, because you said, if you go, when you go and challenge Eli, don't, like, you said yourself, it's like, don't use a weapon or you're a coward. And then I told you, yeah, I smashed that guy when I used my gun on him. You didn't even know what happened when that water hit him. You got me back. You threw a firebomb at me because I kept fucking with him with a water pistol. I wasn't taking him seriously.
Do you know what my experience with that was? I went to the platform, I walked up to him like a boss. He flashed me and threw his machete at me. And then I just, even though I was knocked out, it showed me the prompt. So as I was flashed, I knocked his machete out of the air. I basically bitch slapped his machete. And I was like, okay, come here, kid. And then I CQC'd him. It was so much fun. Alright, let's skip this. No point watching this.
By the way, if
this is gotta be an S rank, right? It's probably an S rank again. The thing is, I wonder if I'll get Foxhound. It's probably not because it's just an octopus. Never mind.
Here's the thing. I suspect this is how the missions are actually meant to be done. Like, with a task, like neutralizing without him knowing. And I think that's the reason why he was so mad at you. Throughout the thing. It's like, you didn't even give me a proper fight, you fucker.
Nah, I think he's more pissed out because you're stronger than him. Even though clearly you're older, more experienced and all that. I don't know. Kid just has issues. I mean, let's not spoil who he is, but yeah, he's got issues. We'll just say that.
But he's not even the one you think he is.
Oh, we're back. Okay, might as well shower then.
You got an elite soldier. That only sucked. Only A++.
Yeah, I don't care about A++ soldiers anymore. I need only S and above, so. Increase morale! I love running past my soldiers just to get the increased morale stuff, and then I just see amazing interaction with the soldiers. Wow. By the way, have you ever tried shooting Cold Talker while you're in the chopper? From time to time he shows up on that platform over there.
The thing
is, you cannot visit him. You can only see him there from time to time when you're in the chopper. If you're on the ground and exploring, you can't go meet him.
Yeah, that's what I'm always wondering, because I tried doing that. I was like, right, I have to go and see him. It's like,
and
he's
never
there. I have to...
He's never there when you want to visit him.
It's like, there has to be like a talk or something, like we can have a nice talk. No? Okay.
Sadly not. Oh yeah, and you asked me about the battle gear, see? On the S difficulty and above, you can actually deploy that shit. I think that's the only thing you can do with it, so...
Yeah, but that's it. Is that really it? A few missions?
So far, I've never used it for anything else, so... I think that's it.
Dude, there has to be something you can use it for. Because even in the fucking portable game, flipping the Zeke you built can do shit.
Is this
you know what? I'm gonna go and play Peace Walker. I'm gonna go
and
play Peace
Walker.
You
know what? This is worth it, I'll take it. Dispatched. No, I used up my soldiers. Never mind.
I wonder how many of our 7 viewers agree. Like, if any of you ever played Peace Walker, wouldn't you rather prefer to have, like, the shit in that game happen here? You know, build
Man,
your own
so
Metal Gear stuff.
Man, you're so butthurt about that game since last night. What's wrong with you? Just enjoy the game for what it is. Like, what the fuck, man?
I'm not saying it's a bad game, don't get me wrong.
I know, but still, enjoy it for what it is.
I guess I was just hoping of a combination between Peace Walker and Metal Gear Solid 4, and it didn't happen, and I was disappointed.
Where is that guy? You know what? Fuck it. Can't find you? Fuck you. Right, what
else?
Doesn't
exist.
I don't wanna farm materials, that's boring. Let's do something else.
What shall you do?
What now?
Hey, why don't you go and fight some Skulls and show us how well you fight them?
It's super easy, what's the point?
What, you're just gonna hit them with rocket? You're not gonna do any of the cool stuff, like use water pistol or anything? Pleb.
No, basically I walk to the anti-air gun, I kill two of them until they destroy the gun, and then I finish the rest, the other two, with my rocket launcher. Too short. What's the point? It's easy.
You're pleb. You
know
have
what's
no
fun?
Style.
Neutralizing
like
them. Try doing that. That's a lot of fun.
You have no style. For instance, if the people watching this now go and watch my honeybee video, you can see me dip diving around, doing all sorts of shit. I'm a scrapper in a fight.
I like being efficient. Scrappy is for those who don't know what they're doing. So there's a few good areas. The oil field is a good area to farm materials, as well as the Nova Braga airport, everybody knows that. But there's actually one more pretty decent spot. Where was that? It's actually not a main camp, it's sort of like a small hidden off area, but for the love of me, I cannot remember where the fuck that shit was. I wanted to point it out. I think I will remember eventually. Is this heavy infantry? You know what? These are kind of close apart. Heavy infantry. You know what? We'll go collect these guys.
Heading to central.
Just in case we run into a chopper, I'll just grab a rocket launcher. Even though I don't wanna do that, I hate grabbing rocket launchers. But if we run into a chopper, that's gonna be a lot of pain, so. You know what? No. We're not doing armored vehicles or anything. If we're just going for heavy soldiers, there's not gonna be choppers. If they're choppers, they're not gonna be part of the main mission. So let's just keep the sniper. But we'll get the weaker version, because there's no point paying for the more expensive one.
Deploying.
Wonder if we should... usually when I go on free roam, I play some music, but... we better not do that now, I think, right? Yeah,
do you know what? I don't know where to find it, but the boss's song.
Snake Eater? Oh, that's pretty easy. I'll show you where it is.
No, is there a version of the boss, you know, humming? Because you remember, like, she sung in, like, Peace Walker. She was like...
I'm not sure. I have to check, I think. Give me a second.
I mean, there's tons of music that I haven't got. I think there's over like 200 songs or something.
I don't think there's that much. But did you know that some of the cassettes can actually be used in the world for various effects?
Yes, like the if you use the alert noise, like the alert noise of the soldiers, they actually go on alert.
There's also songs that can put them to sleep. I find that hilarious every time.
Yeah, if you use it in what was it called? Afghanistan Lullaby?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know what the others do, but I wish you'd find out soon.
I've got some guesses. Let me check the tapes real quick. I think I've got a few left, because basically when you use them once, they're pretty much used up. If you use them, like, properly, bro. Central Africa. Yeah, this is the one that... This one I really wanna try, I've never tried it. The recording in the toilet. I think that when you're hiding in a toilet, nobody's gonna go in there if you play this song. Because it makes sense, right? I'm just assuming because I've never actually used it. Okay, let's stop that because that's fucking disgusting as shit. But yeah, the one you're talking about, the African lullaby. Okay, soldiers in Africa will go to sleep if you play this around them. Just make sure to have the loudspeaker option on, so you know they can hear that shit.
Do you know what the best thing is? Is the fact that you can add your own music.
Yeah, that's
the
best
amazing part,
definitely, by far. So if you want the Snake Eater song, let me see where that mission... I think it was Voices. Yeah, this is the one. So...
Mission accepted. The map has been
updated. No, that's not how it works. Fuck. Let's see. Right, so over here, I think this was the place. Basically, the mission starts. Just a sec. Let me open this again.
Please select a mission.
What is... Right, so you see. Oh, I can zoom actually, never mind. So you see this starting area. Over here, just over a bit to the side, there's a small encampment and like one or two houses. I think there's like one or two soldiers guarding them. And over there you'll find like Snake Eater, the recording. That's pretty much it.
Wait, where? Just there, okay.
Yeah, over here to the side. Right after, near the mission end area. It's mission 20 voices, that's where Snake Eater is. Right, so... Can we like...
Expansion complete.
Cancel
Please
the mission?
Select a mission.
Development we should be able to cancel
has
it, right?
Been added.
How do we cancel a mission? Can I accept this mission cancel? No. Okay, basically I'm not gonna go to the objective area. Gotcha.
Marker placed.
Fuck it. Right, let's go. Oh, lost it. No. Yeah, as tedious as it is, think of it this way. Every time you pick up a flower, you either pick up 5000k or 10000k. When you think of it that way, picking up these flowers is not as tedious. It's actually a lot more rewarding to the brain, trust me. If you wanna make some quick bucks. Right, so I assume since it's pretty high up there, these guys are gonna be armored up the ass, right?
Yes, they are.
And they're also good rank. S rank soldier, okay. Let's see, actually those that are not S rank I'm just gonna kill, I'm not gonna extract.
Analysis complete.
S rank. Okay, two S ranks
Analysis
so far.
Complete.
I'm gonna mark you. Where's the other guy? Just to the side. Oh, is that a snipe team over there or is that just a patrol?
Analysis complete.
Okay, only two S ranks so far. I'll get them. The other guys are gonna die.
Analysis complete.
Honestly, just extracting them would probably be easier than killing them at this point. Unless I take my time and bring them to me, like this guy's gonna come.
Really, you can actually see those people.
Oh, I'm not gonna have to lure him, he's gonna just come perfectly to me. Excellent, look at that. What a good boy you are. Let's get some extra heroism while we're at it. Hey, 5 points, 5 points, nobody gives you that for free, so might as well. Okay, that's one S rank that's out of the area, the other one's up in the tower, which is a bit annoying. Because even if I reveal myself to him, he's gonna send somebody else to check it out. Since there's
he's
people around
too.
Him, he's not gonna
Roger
go check
that.
Himself. And that's annoying. So I don't wanna grab him and knife him because that's gonna increase my demon points. So...
Well, your demon points are decreased by the amount like of heroic deeds you actually do.
Yeah, but I don't wanna do it. This is just a in-character thing for me. I don't wanna do evil things. I wanna be the legendary hero like that they paint me out to be. I wanna play it as such. So I'm not
but it
gonna
doesn't matter.
Him, I'm just gonna
but
him.
In the end, it doesn't matter what you paint yourself to be. In the end, you are going to be the villain.
Yes, I will be. But to myself, I know that I've done the right thing. And that's all that matters to me. I wanna know I did the right thing. That's it.
Well, to David, you're not. You're son.
Is he looking my way? I can't tell, dude. My eyes are so bad right now. I haven't seen the lights night at all. That's why my aim is off today as well.
Jack.
Don't look
By
this
way,
way
do,
bro.
Do we find out the boss's last name?
I'm not sure. I don't think so. Just her, you know, first name.
Yeah. Well...
So yeah, I exploited reflex mode again. I'm doing that quite a lot for this game. Hey, if it lets me, if it's gonna let me exploit it, I'll exploit it up the ass. Fuck it.
Now, I suspect you can, in reflex mode, knock these guys out with mags, right?
No, I think their helmets are gonna protect them. You can't knock him out with Max. I doubt. But I can try if you want. Didi. What's wrong with you? What the fuck, Didi?
Didi, no.
Wait. Did that guy fall off and knock Didi? Oh, Didi is stunned! That guy, when he fell, he knocked Didi out. Oh my god, Didi, don't scare me like that.
Didi, no.
Oh yeah, I gotta kill these guys. Actually, let's kill those guys because... yeah, it's gonna be easier to kill one with a grenade. These guys are gonna be more of a problem. Right, I'm gonna throw a grenade. I don't think a grenade's enough to kill them, so I'm gonna have to throw like more than one probably. Oh shit, they noticed me. Well, yeah, that happens when you run. Oh well. Just kill them now. Yeah, one's definitely not enough. Two grenades. Didi, why are you there? And your helmet socks will die. So oddly enough, if you knife them, you get demon points. But if you straight up kill them with a gun, no matter how they are and what they're doing, game doesn't care. When they're knocked out, is one grenade enough? No, it's not enough. Okay, good to know. What are you doing, Snake? Get down there. You look ridiculous in that box. Snake! Do what I'm telling you to do!
Now, here's the thing some people get confused by, is the use of Big Boss and Snake for both of him. Like, I've heard plenty of my friends going, what is he? Is he Venom Snake or is he Big Boss?
He's both.
Yeah, exactly.
So how does this make sense? See, I can't hit him through the helmet. How? How is the helmet protecting him right there? I don't get it.
Magic.
Wait, why am I hearing noises?
Extraction. Oh, noises.
Doesn't matter, somebody was talking. At least it felt like it.
Yeah, okay, so you want to be a hero, right?
Yeah.
So having unconscious people, throwing grenades at them and then popping them in the head is heroic.
My mission is to either extract them or kill them. I don't want to extract them, so I kill them.
That's demon!
No, the game says that I don't get demon points because the alarm doesn't play. If you knife them while you're holding them, that gives you demon points. If you just kill them, you don't get demon points. So, there you go.
Yeah,
totally heroic!
Totally heroic.
Right. Oh, let's check out if we have any S-rank soldiers here.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
No, oddly enough, usually whenever I run into an encampment on this point, there's at least one S rank soldier. I'm honestly surprised that there's nobody in this one, or at least I'm not seeing him. Oh, there's some red containers, though. Nah, I don't need them. Yeah, there was 15k biological materials just sitting there, but whatever. Maybe that's the place with the lot of resources actually. Was that the place I was talking about earlier? Because there's a lot of containers in it. And there's definitely more than two red ones. Yeah, maybe this is the place actually. So yeah, maybe check out this area. Maybe this was the area I was talking about. Here it is, near the Umbuga Industrial Zone. Where you can get like a lot of materials as well. At the very least, we saw that there's like 15k biomaterials, so there you go. And there's a lot of side ops in this area, so you'll be running through this area a lot. So you can just pick them up on your way. Oh, and check this out, there's also a lot of materials on this side as well. So basically between this area and this area, these two areas, you can get a lot of materials. Yeah, and they're relatively like, there's pretty much no fucking guards. You can like easily get both areas without like running into any trouble.
Analysis complete.
Yeah, see, just there's like just a few guards in both areas. It's pretty fucking easy. Also, keep in mind when you're going on FOB missions and when you're completing main missions, I think for main missions also it works. All the resources and the stuff in the world pretty much respawn, so you don't have to wait a couple of days. You just go and grab what you need, pretty much. I remember when I was like doing 4 and 5 side missions on the side, and then somebody attacked my FOB. I went and defended my FOB, killed the bastard, and when I returned, basically everything in the world immediately respawned. So I just went and did the same thing twice in a row. And as you can imagine, I got a lot of cool shit for it. Come on, Snake. There we go. Good boy. Let's see what we're dealing with over here. Oh, this is gonna be easy. Yeah, one thing I don't like about the side missions is you'll notice that from time to time they seem to be exactly the same. Like, four soldiers, two at each end. I've done this mission 3 times already. 3 side ops, exactly the same. Why, game? Why? And these guys are trash. Look at them. They're not even like only one A soldier. Like what the fuck? What are these trashes doing here? Wait, what was his skill? No, it's a grenade launchers, whatever. So yeah, why? Why am I doing this for the 3rd fucking time? Why? I wonder if that barrel can. No, I can use a grenade for that. I'm gonna have some fun with that later. Let's first get rid of these guys. Actually, no, wait, I've got an even better idea. Nah, I should probably leave this for last. I was just gonna pile them up over here.
Just pile up the bodies.
Right, so how does your helmet protect you, bro? I don't get it, but there you go. Whatever. I should have brought
hey,
some
C4. Apparently, you know, bullets can't hurt them, but you can easily, like, punch them down.
Yeah. I don't know, man. Nothing in this game makes sense, that's all I'm gonna say. I wonder if the battle's gonna be enough to kill them, bro. Don't wanna risk it, so I'll stay here. Just in case. No! It didn't kill him. What? How did they avoid the 2nd barrel explosion? What the fuck? Oh, the explosion knocked off all their armor though, and nobody heard the thing, so whatever. Let's go take the others. I've got something special planned for the guy up there. Just basically gonna throw a grenade at him. Should be fun. I wonder if the height is gonna at least kill him. And the barrel. The barrel should help with this. Let's see. Oh yeah, that definitely killed him. Nice. There we go. That should do.
Oh my god! Really? Wow, that didn't even wake him up!
There we go. I shot him in the leg.
Oh, that was funny!
It was but a tickle.
Wait, do I hear a truck? Mine! Mine! This truck is mine! Oh wait, they went off the truck. That means I don't have to use my weapon, I can just kill them this way. My truck! Get away from my truck. Are you guys
analysis
worth it?
Complete. Analysis
no, you're
complete.
Not. I should have killed you. Never mind. Mine. So yeah, basically when I hear a truck, I run straight for the road and I'm like, mine! Mine! That's what happens every time. Right, so these are kind of far now. I don't wanna bother running over there. Like, don't need to waste time doing that. I'll do that on my own time.
Extraction arrived at Mud of Psydops list updated. Please select a mission. Unit dispatched. Unit dispatched.
I might as well do something.
Unit dispatched.
I've never done any of these missions that you use to cripple the enemy. I don't know why, I don't like them. Let's see. How are we doing soldier wise? So, I gotta start fading out the A rank soldiers. I actually still can get a lot of A++ and A+ soldiers, but I don't wanna bother with those guys anymore. I get them from the vehicles that I extract, like tanks and other armored vehicles anyway, no point farming those.
Yeah, sure.
I just need to make sure I get more of the S-rank soldiers and up.
Please select a mission.
See. Oh yeah, this mission. Oh man, doing this mission without quiet is gonna be such a pain. I remember in the middle of the mission I got rid of Didi and summoned quiet just because, dude, I needed so much fire support. Like basically the one where you gotta watch over the kids, you gotta carry one on your back and there's soldiers up the ass everywhere. Ugh, mission was annoying. This one I did horribly. Like, the way this mission worked out for me is Didi found me the man I'm looking for, like, right off the bat. And I just extracted him and won the mission. And I did it like in 3 minutes or something, it was insane. And apparently because I did it like that, the mission is considered just an A rank. Because, oh, there's so much shit you didn't do, like, fuck you game, just fuck you. Whatever, I'll redo it eventually, I guess. Oh yeah, I gotta redo the first missions. Haven't done them. Like at all. Oh, this one was so much fun. The one that you mentioned. With the bees. I don't understand why they make you start so far away from the mission area. So you can like explore the world and shit, but still. Really dude, why are you making me go through all this shit? What's the point? This one was hilarious. I literally walked in the room with the three commanders and just took them out with reflex mode and that was it. Yeah, I gotta start doing some missions. Whatever.
Bye. Please select a mission. Unit dispatched. Please select a mission.
Right, so... No wait, this is not the one. Ludron's Deep. Traitor's Caravan, was that it? Yeah, this is the one where you fight the skulls. Basically, the Traitor's Caravan, you can just bypass most of the mission, go to the airport immediately, just run there. trigger the skulls knock everybody out. Kill the skulls, don't extract the truck, just extract all the soldiers. This is what basically people have been using to farm soldiers. And it's a waste of fucking time, like I said. Once you have enough heroism, you don't need to farm soldiers. The thing is, though, now that I have a lot of heroism, is it gonna spawn a lot of good soldiers? I highly doubt that, considering we did like on the trail mission 26 or something, where there are a lot of good soldiers patrolling the area, and we didn't get anything that scales up. So I kinda don't wanna waste time, it's probably not gonna give us anything good. But somebody can try it with a lot of heroism if they want. Honestly, I do not wanna waste time doing that shit. Here's the mission that's farmed for fuel, precious materials and minor minerals. Actually, you know what, I'm just gonna start it so I can show it. It's super fast and super easy. You know what? I should get the water gun, that's what I need for this mission.
Yes! Actually, the water gun is quite good.
Well, here's the thing, where do you equip the water gun? I don't think I've ever used it. Yeah, instead of... Can you knock people out with the water gun?
No, but you can blind them.
You know what, fuck it, I wanna try it. From what I know, the water gun's only real use is... wait, I don't need DD.
Skulls are also stunned by it as well.
Well, yeah, because... Oh my god, water, fuck yeah, we love water. They're weird.
Oh, water! Water's so good!
Quiet is the only one I can respect because she actually goes in the water and creates rainbows. But never mind that now. The thing that's cool about the water gun is instead of using C4s or turning off the power and stuff like that in bases that you're infiltrating, you can just squirt water on them. One, you're silent. Two, you take them out permanently, which is amazing!
But yeah, someone just asked, does anybody know why the story stopped after 55%? That's because I think it's taken up by all the extra stuff.
So the way the percentage works, basically when you complete the main missions without doing anything else, you should be at maybe 40, 50%, something like that, right?
No doubt about it.
After that, what happens is like the rest is the side ops, the tapes, the collectibles, and getting S rank and all the other like side things on the main missions. That's how you 100% it. Actually, let me check if these guys are worth taking out. No. Oh, you're shitty. Where's the other guy? Where's go? Oh, there we go. What's up? Tell me where all your friends are, or I'm gonna squirt you with my gun.
You can actually hold people up, yeah.
Actually, no. You know what? I don't wanna knock him out. But it's already too late. Hello.
Analysis complete.
Oh, S rank. There we go. I'll take him. Actually, can you wake them up if you squirt them with the gun? This should make sense, right?
Maybe.
Oh yeah! See, he woke up! What?
Squirt, squirt.
Dude, you okay? Okay. I don't understand what's happening right now. Get up. No, no, get up, get up. Get up! I told you to get up.
The guy kept standing and just...
Get up. Over here, turn around. I'm behind you, turn around! Okay, drop your gun as well. There we go, he's got no weapons left. What are you gonna do now, bro? Got no weapons left. I'm gonna let you go now. So... Squirt, squirt. It's just a water gun. Why are you scared of me? You know what? I can respect that. You know, I'm a legendary soldier. Of course you'd be scared. Just get down, bro. You're fine. I'll leave you alone now.
Yeah, it's like Riddick killing somebody with a teacup.
So yeah, basically, when you start this mission, there's two soldiers. And then you get up these stairs, you obviously need the wormhole, otherwise it's not gonna work. We get one container for precious materials. One for fuel, and all of them are the fatty ones, all the fatty containers. Last one is, yeah, it's minor materials. So you just quickly go, collect this stuff. What you do after this is, you go over there to that intel file. Once you collect the intel file, just, you know, skip the cutscene first of all. When it gives you the right, the mission saves. At this point, all you have to do is restart the mission. Once you restart the mission, everything is just like your first round. The containers have respawned, the soldiers have respawned, and everything that you extracted has been saved. So basically, every 2 minutes you can pick up a lot of precious materials, a lot of minor materials, and a lot of fuel. The two most important things in this game are GMP and fuel. Precious materials are worth a lot of GMP, and you get a fuel container, 7.5k every time. So every 2 minutes you can get everything you need in the game. So once you know this, you can grind like up the ass everything. See, everything's respawned. But here's the thing, this gets monotonous real quick, and it's annoying. That's why I've only done it once or twice to test out how it works. I actually recommend you just going over the bases, the big ones, the Afghani base, the OKB base, and in Africa, the other like two major places, the airfield and the airfield. Just go collect soldiers, extract the things, do a side ops, then come back to the area. Everything will respond anyway, so there's no point doing one thing over and over again. You can just do the more fun things, explore the world and do stuff like that. There's no point like doing this thing. No point. It's dumb. It's a waste of fucking time. There's also one mission. The only thing that you don't get a lot of here is like obviously the common materials. But there's that mission with the kids after the White Mamba where you have to extract like a person and another child commander. You basically spawn in the mission area. You run like 200 meters. Collect about 8,000 or 9,000 common materials and then you restart the mission. And that's it. You can farm those there as well. But yeah, like I said, these things are not fun to do. No point. Here's something else that's easy if you don't wanna grind and still get a lot of fuel though. That I actually recommend doing. In Afghanistan.
Mission accepted.
Uh-huh. Over here, the big OKB base that unlocks after you defeat Skullface and stuff like that. Basically, if you go here, in the main area there's gonna be 4 fuel containers, all the fatty type. And then there's gonna be a few extra containers over here, they're also red. And there's a few white containers over here, so there's a lot of cool shit you can pick up here. Relatively easy. You just roll in with a tank in the battle dress. First of all, when you're in a tank, unless you kill someone or bump into something, they're not gonna notice it's an enemy. They're gonna think it's one of their tanks. So you can sneak in with a fucking tank through the main door. Yes, you can do that. And once you're inside, you just extract the containers and you return immediately to the chopper with the escape key without any hassle. Actually, you know what? It's so fucking easy, I'm gonna do it right now just to show you. Actually, armored vehicle unit. Oh, fuck, I gotta get rid of these guys first of all. Right, let's get rid of those guys. Armored vehicle, that means I'm gonna need a rocket launcher. Because there's gonna be a fucking chopper, you just know there's gonna be one. Man, the water gun's surprisingly fun, I should use it more. I don't know why when they're knocked out, you can just like squirt them, they get up, they look annoyed and then they just go back down. That was weird. Has that ever happened to you? Is that supposed to be a thing?
No, that's... I have never tried it and I am surprised that it did that, to be honest.
Well, there you go. If nothing else, if you learned nothing new on this stream, at least you saw how the water pistol works and you had a lot of fun watching that. So you're welcome. There you go. Wow, the water pistol's amazing, dude. I gotta play with it more. It's a shame that it takes up the slot for my tranquilizer gun, but oh well. So, I'm a little bit worried that there's gonna be a chopper, and as soon as I'm departing, it's gonna fucking immediately spot me. and so I'm gonna have to do this like on alert status. I'm not gonna be silent. If I wanted to be silent, I had to land somewhere else, and I don't wanna walk because I'm lazy. So let's see what happens. Also, I should have probably used the battle dress for this mission, but whatever. Wait, is there no chopper? I don't see a chopper. Is it on the other side? Did I miss the chopper? Oh, they spotted me already, so that's what they expected, I guess. There's the armored vehicle. There's two of them actually, nice.
Be careful down there, boss.
Let's take them. Okay, there's no chopper, that's awesome. Now, where's the enemy? Okay, we have a sniper. There's gotta be more snipers around here. Didi just can't spot them, they're probably way too far away. No! Okay then. Well, now I'm very sad that I got the rocket launcher because I need a sniper. Oh well. Oh, there's the snipers, okay. Let's see if there's any good
ones. Analysis complete.
No, these guys are absolute fucking garbage. Okay. Let's start by taking the vehicles. You know what? Everything else can fucking wait. Let's grab the vehicles. I should probably not do the frog hop because they might spot me. I'm not 100% sure. Not gonna risk it. After that, we're gonna call in a tank and just go right through the front door because we're bosses like that. We're not gonna be sneaking into the most OP base in Afghanistan. Oh, scary. Right. Nobody's gonna see me here, right? Yoink. Mine. So I should probably go take out that sniper group or that sniper group. But I'm just gonna YOLO because fuck it. It's right here. I'm greedy like that. I might just die and look horribly, or I'm gonna get into a scrappy fight. But there you go, man. That's how it goes sometimes. Nope, we're fine. I spotted nothing! Are you guys okay? Or should I kill you?
Complete.
You
shit.
Him.
Oh, shit, okay, you're dying.
Boss, get down.
Ooh, is that not a headshot?
No way.
Stop lagging. Keep it together, game. Okay, are you guys worth getting? Let's see. Are you gonna live or are you gonna die?
Complete. Analysis
you
complete.
Are both dead. There we go. Two more. Do the frog. Ribbit, ribbit.
Too far.
Ribbit, ribbit. No. Can I?
As a true kleptomaniac, I always
That should be good enough, right? Apparently it wasn't. Okay. Good to know. Okay, that's one down. It's gonna bleed out if I don't shoot. Oh, he's concerned about his buddy end up nice. Right, so I'm just gonna push you off, right? Is that okay, bro? Oh shit! He knifed me! You fucker! Thanks, Didi. Wow! What an asshole! He knifed me! Can you believe that? And I just wanted to push him off a cliff. Wow! And he's alive. Wow. Okay. Here's a grenade. Eat up. What? Why did it go all the way there? Come on, just die. Ah, that's annoying. Fucking grenades. Can you die now? Wow, finally. Jesus. Thanks, Didi. Wow. That was weird. But whatever. Okay, let's put him out of his misery. Okay. Right. Let's summon a tank and go have fun.
Side ops list updated.
I've never actually summoned a vehicle when I'm out in the field. Let's see if that's like at mother base. Usual. Ammo? No, I don't want ammo.
Clouds approaching.
Supply drop. Vehicles, yeah, there we go, okay. So let's get a vehicle.
Please select a drop supply.
I wonder, usually you know that if you click on yourself and you don't move, the box is gonna fall on you. What happens if a tank falls on you? I wonder.
You probably die.
Yeah, complete. Safe bet. Where's my tank? Oh, there we go, it's coming. Isn't that cute? Tanks on delivery. It's amazing, dude. It's amazing what they would deliver to your doorstep at this point. Have you noticed? Dude, I'm pretty sure that there's some badass in the world out there that if he delivers a nuke to his doorsteps, somebody's gonna fucking deliver a nuke to him. I don't know, I feel like it. There's probably a guy like that out there. That says, I want a nuke, so they're gonna deliver a nuke to him.
Marker placed.
They actually have a mission in that area. Let me just double check real quick what's the mission. Prisoner extraction. Okay, maybe we'll do it, maybe. Now let's see how we can sneak inside this top secret facility without us being noticed. Shh. There's definitely not a solid snake inside the tank.
There is no solid... there is no snake within this tank. You do not understand.
So yeah, even before you go into the main facility, you can see that there's actually some red containers over here on the side. See how they're they actually run and jump out of the way because they're scared that their friendlies are gonna knock them over. Also,
hey,
I don't know why, but every time I come with a tank here, I always knock that tree over. I can never fucking miss that tree.
By the way, do you think if you colored your tank in like ridiculous colors, they would still let you through? It's like, wow, that guy knows how to pimp his tank.
I don't know, man, I've never tried. Honestly, you know what? If somebody comes to me with a pimped out tank, I'll be like, just kill me, bro, you're way too swag, just kill me.
Like a solid gold tank.
See? They're just jumping out of the way, they're scared of me, but they think I'm a friend. Right, so this is the hard part. Okay, we got through in one go. So yeah, they think there's something worth checking out, they're not sure. Okay, so white containers over here, we're gonna keep going until we see the real booty. So yeah, no alarms are gonna be raised because they think I'm a friendly tank. Literally, they do not think that an enemy would ride up in one of their tanks and just enter the base. Okay, here's the first part, here's where the real money is at. See? Four red containers all stacked up. And over there inside, there's like one or two more red containers as well. So, good shit. Right now, we're gonna trigger the alarm because... fuck it, I don't care. Okay, I wanted to be sneaky for a little bit more. Can I be? Is this the only guy that noticed me? No. Oh yes, he is. I'm fine. So just die. There we go. I'm still undetected and I'm inside the main base. I rode with a tank. I got out of the tank and I'm still undetected. This is how easy it is to get the good shit. Yoink. And by the way, yes, you have a lot of side ops in this base to extract school soldiers and prisoners. So even if you don't grind this or worry about coming here all the time, you can still get so much shit. Like basically just do side ops from time to time and you'll be getting this shit left and right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the prisoner's over there. Maybe we'll collect him, maybe. For now, let's go get the other red containers outside. Just so we can show them where they are. Right, how the fuck do I get out of this building? There's gotta be a door. Oh shit, it's just one side? Ah, fuck it, I don't care. I'm not doing this stealth for this one first. I rolled up with a tank, this is not a stealth run, people, okay? Okay. Honestly, it's still... actually, it's still a stealth run, technically. But... whatever. Right. So, until he knocks me, I'm just not gonna shoot, no problem. I'm gonna exploit reflex mode again. So yeah, one container... oh, actually, three containers, there you go. So if you come over here, there's like three more extra red containers, and these ones are precious materials, 500 each, which means 1000 precious materials, and the precious material is worth 1000k once it's processed, which means that in these two containers alone, that's 1 million GMP. That's it, 1 million GMP from those two containers alone once you process them, that's it. And all the other stuff is just a nice little bonus. you get a lot of fuel and extra materials. It's amazing. This place is just so awesome. And you don't even GMP need the wormhole, you can just come with the normal photons and still be just fine. Now let's go get the prisoner. Who spotted me? Am I blind? Oh, he spotted me. Really? Through the wall? No one spotted you, I don't care anymore, it's fine. Like I said, this ain't exactly stealth, so...
You're doing well up to this point.
Yeah, whatever. Even without the silencer, if you're just firing a normal arm, as long as nobody has spotted you, the alarm is probably rung or not, I don't care, but reflex mode is still can still be enabled. So just kill everybody that sees you. And even if shit's not going your way, it's still super easy to do whatever the fuck you want. Yeah, see, basically, it triggers every time. Whatever. So yeah, at this point, now I got spotted for real. So it's not gonna matter. Reflex mode is not gonna kick in anymore. But I'm at the prisoner, so it doesn't matter. Oh shit, it's not open. Where's he going? He's going towards the prisoner, that's kinda bad. Oh no, he's going up. That's fine. Totally fine with that. So yeah, now I don't have reflex mode to exploit, so it's a little bit harder. I have to be a little more careful. Oh no, somebody spots. Fuck, don't kill me! Oh my god, why am I picklocking the door? Come on, please. Fuck yes. Okay. Extract him, and once he's extracted, I'm leaving. Okay, so yeah, you're in this base, you're in a lot of trouble, but you're not on a main mission, so this is what happens. Mission completed, return to AC, you're done. Easy. There you go. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Right. And we got a shit ton of resources for that.
Yeah, guy, I think we may have to end the stream pretty soon, by the way.
Oh, is it time for the D&D campaign?
Yeah, it's almost time.
Oh shit, I guess we took longer than I thought. So, guys, for those of you that don't know, we're called the D&D Gamers, because we do D&D type campaigns. Right now I'm the GM of Dungeon World campaign, so feel free to check it out. Right now we'll be recording our session. We upload them like... two or three weeks back, is that how it works? Like, it's almost up to date, doesn't matter. So check it out if you wanna see how we're having fun in our spare time. I had a lot of fun actually doing this stuff, but in Metal Gear, honestly, once you know how to get the resources and the money, everything else just doesn't matter, apart from getting the soldiers, which, like I said already many times, farming soldiers is a waste of fucking time, just get heroism. Right, so I guess we can just record and upload some things that we find funny, like finding the rainbows and water pistols and what else we can think of and doing and crazy bullshit like that. But apart from that, I can't think of anything else I wanna do on stream with Metal Gear unless you guys wanna watch somebody else play for the main missions and side ops, which I don't see why you'd wanna do that instead of doing that yourself, because you can have fun. But if you have some questions about what's going on, you wanna ask me some tips on something, on a mission or how to do something, just make sure to like post it in the comment section or PM us in a private message. Doesn't matter, whatever you want, just let us know, we'll help you out. For now, that's about it, because I gotta go be a GM for like DM for like 4 or 5 hours, and I hope my voice doesn't give out. I hope you guys had fun, and yeah, from now on we'll be streaming a lot. The next time I'll be streaming is definitely gonna be within the next week, because there's a game I wanna stream, and I'll keep streaming more games that come out, like StarCraft Legacy of the Void is about to come out, and I'm definitely gonna stream for the entire campaign the day it comes out. I'm basically not gonna sleep, gonna do it in one go, because I'm a huge StarCraft nerd and I'm a Protoss bro, so there you go. And yes, that's about it. So thank you guys for stopping by, thank you for chatting, I hope you guys had fun. And I'll
goodbye.
See you maybe next time. Who knows? Goodbye.